Are you ready to see how Google Ads work? Woo, the crowd goes wild. Well, I actually find Google Ads really exciting, and I've been managing Google Ads since 2009. In this video, I'm gonna walk you through the three types of Google Ads: search, display, and video. And I'll be showing you on my computer exactly how they work within Google Ads. And at the end of this video, I'll actually be showing you how you can get a free course, a free 8-hour course on Google advertising if you want to go more in depth into it. Let's get it. First off, let's start with the three different types of ads you can place on Google. You have search ads, which show up on Google search. You have display ads, which show up on other sites on the internet. And then you have video ads, which show up on YouTube. I'm gonna go over each of these different ads on my computer right here. And I'll even be showing you examples of some ads that I've placed that have worked really well for me over the years. Here we are, google.com, and this is the, you know, we're just gonna search for, you know, I'm fat, how do I lose weight? And here we go. We see first thing here is an ad, right? So this is the first type of Google ad, Google search ad. And generally speaking, you target these through keywords. And I'll be going into AdWords and showing you how you actually set these up in a second. Okay, second type of ad is display ads. And display ads show up on other websites. Here's a site for, you know, the 11 best diapers to buy in 2019, you know, on news sites or blogs or whatever. And you'll see this right here is an ad. And you see it says advertisement right here. And you can, you know, you can click this little thing and it will talk to you about those ads right here. You can also see ads that show up on the right-hand side here. Ad, another ad, you have another ad. You have ads all over the place, you know, they're everywhere. That's how lots of sites make money, is they show ads. In this site's case, they are also making money through affiliate marketing. So all of these links here, you see link, 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 and you see buy on Amazon. This person is a member of Amazon's affiliate program. That's what I do for a living. I do affiliate marketing. If you want to learn more about that, I'm going to have my Filipino or Filipina assistant put up a link to my free course on affiliate marketing somewhere up here, or you can subscribe to my channel and see more information about that. And then the third type of ad is on YouTube. So I just searched for lose weight fast, and you see you get an ad right here which says my son lost 100 pounds in 6 months and an amazing and inspiring transformation. A proud and driven mom, she takes a chance on a book found on Amazon, right? And this is a video ad, and you can place this through YouTube ads, which is, YouTube is a part of Google if you weren't aware. So let's go over to Google, and here we are in Google. Google Ads, if you haven't signed up for it, you just search Google Ads. I'm assuming you're familiar with Google Ads. It used to be called AdWords, but since they do video and all this other stuff now, they changed it. And how we would set up a campaign is, the first step is we would go over to this campaign section right here, and we would select that, and then we would select this plus button right here. And we simply say select new campaign. Now, they give you a lot of selections. In Google Ads, the interface changes like literally on a weekly basis. It's kind of overwhelming, and it's kind of nutty. You know, I've been doing advertising on Google since 2009, so I've seen a lot of changes, and it's frustrating that it keeps changing, but it's something you kind of got to roll with. Now, these selections may change, or they may What I actually like the most is this. Just create a campaign without goals guidance, because these selections kind of limit the features that you're able to use, and sometimes it makes your ads unprofitable. So don't do that. Now it'll give you some more selections, and this is where you really define what sort of ads you set up. Now, what I'm gonna do for the case of, for the purposes of this video, is I'm just gonna set up a search ad. Now, if you'd like to see me set up other types of ads, such as display, shopping, video, or app-based ads, let me know in the comments. And I can do, if somebody's comment about one of these gets a ton of likes, I will do a video on that. But for now, I'm just gonna focus on one, otherwise we'd be here for like hours, because there's, you know, it's a really in-depth program. So here we say, what results do we want from the campaign? And if you are a local business, phone calls is actually a great option. Or if you don't have a website, highly suggest you do phone calls. You can advertise on Google without a website, and I don't think people understand that, you know. Businesses and they just want phone calls. So you can do that very easily. And all you have to do is enter your phone number. You don't even need a website. But for our purposes and for most people advertising on the internet, they want website visits. Okay, so we're going to select that. And I'm just going to type in my website, which is iamjetset.com. Okay, click continue. I'm just going to title this search demo. It doesn't really matter what you name your campaign. One thing that Google does that's a little bit sneaky is I said I wanted to set up a search ad. It also gives me options to, it's already pre-checked for the search network and the display network. Now, you could thumb over these icons and figure out what the display network is, but check this out. 2 million websites, videos, and apps. The display network is a whole other can of worms and requires a whole different type of targeting, whole different type of ad, whole different type of landing page or funnel experience typically. If you're doing a search ad, in like 99.999% of cases, you're just gonna throw away money if you have display network added. I've never actually seen it work where display network is active on an ad. The other thing I would throw off in most cases is the search network. Sometimes I test it out for beginner advertisers. You don't want to advertise on the search network, because what the search network is it includes other sites that are not google.com. Where it's going to advertise on, such as, you know, AOL.com as an example, but there are many other sites, and Google doesn't tell you what those sites are, but just a lot of other sites use Google's ads. It's a good way to waste a lot of money, so you want to uncheck those if you care about not losing money on your advertising. If you're a big corporate company, might not, you know, you have budgets, so it might not matter that much. Okay, we don't need to worry about dynamic search ads. In our case, we're just gonna leave United States checked, locations, and enter in more locations, we have English, and we have our budget. Now, generally speaking, you know, you can just say, oh, I wanna spend $100 a day. You know, I wouldn't recommend spending anything less than $20 a day if you're going on Google, because you won't get much traffic. You know, there's millions of people out. Advertising on Google, and it's hard to get Google's kind of algorithm, you know, the way the Google machine thinks to serve ads. You know, they're looking over all of their millions of people who are advertising, and if your budget is set at $20, it doesn't work as well if it's below $20. So we'll just set $20. Now, what we can focus on for bidding, what I actually recommend, they have an option to optimize based on conversions. What I actually recommend when you're starting is clicks, okay? Once again, Google can overspend if you're doing conversions. This can be a good way to waste a lot of money if you're doing that. So I would start here and move on to conversions if you're more advanced and if you can test against your campaign. Now, I don't necessarily recommend doing a CPC bid when you start, or I don't recommend, and these are all additional things. So don't worry about all this stuff. Then we just click save and continue. Okay, now you see up in the top, it has the different flow of what we'll do. So we'll set up our campaign settings, which is our budget. Then we're gonna set up our ad group. Then we're gonna create our ads, and then it just kind of says thank you. So here we have our ad group, and I'm just gonna say, you know, YouTube demo. And you paste in the keywords that you want to target. Now, in my case, I'm teaching people how to do affiliate marketing. That website, I Am Jet Set, teaches people how to do affiliate marketing. So I was targeting that. I would want to target keywords such as how to do affiliate marketing. I would do that, okay? Or you could enter in ideas and you could say, you know, get keywords ideas. It says how to make extra money, and I could just do plus, you know, how to make extra money from home. You know, how to make extra money online. So those could be my keywords, and then I would say, okay, cool, that sounds good. Generally speaking, an ad group should have somewhere between 5 to 15 keywords, okay? That's a good mix of keywords. Now, my actual, now, that's a general rule of thumb. My style is, I would actually use the keyword planner, which is a little beyond this, but let's say I'd do it this way. So I would do 3 different types of matches. This is what I call the simplest ad group possible. I type in affiliate marketing. I would do modified broad match, which is using plus. This is a bit of an advanced tactic. Don't worry about this if you don't understand it. I would do phrase match, affiliate marketing, and I would do exact match. And then I'd click save and continue. Okay, and then you create your ads and you type in whatever it is. You know, your website URL, I'd say, you know, want to earn money at home, like working in your pajamas, go to my site, yo. You know, that would be my ad, and it gives you a preview of how it shows up. So that's how to do Google Ads. Then we just submit the ad and all that jazz. Hopefully that helps. This information I shot a couple years ago, but it's still relevant and we're still using it in my business to this day. So hope that helps. Make sure you like this video if you got some value from it. Comment below if you have any questions or requests for future video. I'm looking forward to seeing you sometime in my next video.